Thousands of high school teenagers from more than 40 countries have gathered in Houston, Texas for a sporting event unlike any other.
Welcome to First Champ Live.
Yes, cameras are rolling, refs are regulating, and the crowd is cheering. But look closely.
Red team, 21-0-2.
This is a test of brain over brawn, of man over machine. This is the World Championships of High School Robotics. 408 teams, 6 fields, and it's all the brainchild of this man.
Hey, I'm an inventor. What do inventors do? We look at the same problems as everybody else, but see them differently.
Dean Kamen may be the most famous and successful inventor of our time. No, he didn't invent the wheel, but he did invent the Segway. And before creating an unconventional way to travel, Kamen invented an unconventional sport. Yes, he says, a sport.
You want kids to love math and science and engineering, you start with what works. Oh, that's right, sports and entertainment.
Thank you for what you do, sir.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
As far as Kamen is concerned, the world doesn't need more kids who want to be like Mike. It needs more kids who want to be like, well, him.
You're such a motivation to me.
Thank you.
You changed my life.
Thank you. Yeah.
Very few kids that are playing basketball are going to end up 7 feet tall and in the NBA. Very few. But there are a couple of million jobs out there desperately waiting for smart, well-prepared kids with a passion for problem solving. And that's what FIRST creates.
FIRST is the name of Kamen's competitive robotics league, designed to recruit the next generation of problem solvers.
Robot coming through. Choose us, robot.
Teams compete in regional competitions.
All right, you got it. Get another.
In the hope of advancing to the world championships.
Our name is for inspiration and recognition of science and technology. But it's also FIRST because I've never seen kids running around at a sporting event of any sport cheering, I want to be second. So I said, we'll create a sport, which the only difference between our sport and the others is in our sport, every kid can turn pro. Every kid.
There are plenty of grown-ups who would say, Dean, robotics is not a sport.
Yes, I agree with you. A lot of adults will have a hard time believing that our sport is like every other sport. It has exciting outcomes that you don't know till the buzzer. Everything about it is a sport.
A lot of people, they say, is FIRST a sport? And I say, totally, I'm a mathlete. I am competing.
What's a mathlete?
Mathlete, so someone who focuses all their time on mathematics, science, technology, engineering.
Senior Braden Wright designs pieces for his robotics team in New Hampshire.
Whoa, that needs to be fixed.
The team's season begins each year in January. That's when Dean Kamen reveals exactly what kind of robot the students will be expected to build. Afterwards, teams have 6 weeks, known as build season, to bring their robot to life.
When FIRST gives us our challenge, we come together, we have a strategy session, we say, what do we want to do this year? How will we win? And then I come in, I do CAD, computer-aided design, and I design the parts of the robot that will actually accomplish these tasks.
Every year, the challenge changes. In years past, students have had to build robots that can do all sorts of sporty things, from making a basket, to throwing a frisbee, to scoring a goal.
We're coming to you live from Manchester, New Hampshire, the home of FIRST.
This year, hundreds of students showed up in Kamen's hometown, and thousands more watched online to see what Kamen had in store.
Everybody around the world, and 3, 2, 1.
And just like that, the competition was on.
So what's the point of the game?
So the point of the game is to get as many of those cubes into your goal. They're worth big points if you get them way up into that goal, up in the air. But of course, it's much harder for a robot to pick it up and either climb up there, or some of the robots you'll see were designed to throw them.
Kamen's imaginative thinking started at an early age on Long Island, New York. Only it wasn't nurtured in the classroom, where Kamen struggled with dyslexia.
While I didn't do well in school and I didn't like being in classes, I loved education. I loved learning. And I started spending more time on my own trying to understand the world.
You started inventing.
I did start inventing things.
Tick off for me what you invented as a kid.
As a kid, I was trying to make my bed myself. I once noticed my mom using a clothesline and decided I could use those pulleys, connect with the other side of the bed. I could stand at one corner. I could pull with this and act like I had an assistant.
You made a bed-making system.
I made an automatic bed maker. It was never a big seller.
What was a big seller? Auto syringe. A portable device designed to give patients small doses of medicine. It was so successful, Kamen dropped out of college.
I basically told my parents, I can't go to college, take all the courses, finish their stuff, and also keep supplying the needs of these docs.
You were making money at your inventions.
Oh, yes.
Did you make more money than your parents?
There were a couple of those years, yeah.
Over the years, Kamen's inventions have made him a reported $500 million.
I believe this is an elegant-looking flying sports car.
He lives in a multi-storied mansion in New Hampshire, which he, of course, designed himself. It's part home, part museum, with a surprise around every single corner. Or, better yet, right through the front door.
So, wow, what's that?
So that is was a steam engine that ran a magnificent steam tugboat well over 100 years ago.
Oh, my goodness.
That pulled the tall ships in and out of London Harbor.
So does it work?
Well, right now I power it with air, and if you'll watch, it will fire up.
Your house is amazing.
Thank you. I hate to steal his line, but Bill Gates said to me, Dean, I've been to a lot of interesting places, but I'd have to tell you, the only way to describe your house is it's a cross between a museum of science and technology and Willy Wonka's chocolate factory.
Kamen's actual factory, where his newest visions come to life, is just a few miles across town. Here, some 500 employees design and build Kamen's latest and greatest inventions. Like the slingshot, used to purify drinking water in third world countries, and the iBot, a wheelchair that gives its users a new level of freedom.
We build a device that essentially, like a person, will balance. Watch what happens. I'm now on two wheels. And now, on two wheels, I can pivot on two points like a ballerina.
Is it fair to say you have literally hundreds of things that you've been part of inventing?
Yes.
Where does the invention of first rank in the things you care about?
I firmly believe the single project that I devote time and attention to that will have the largest and most long-term impact on the world is first.
That's because, Kamen says, first isn't just about getting students excited to build robots. It's about changing what they think is possible for their future.
We have a culture crisis, particularly for women and minorities. Let's just change the culture back to one in which kids, all kids, start to see math and science and analytic thinking and creating and inventing as every bit as accessible and exciting and rewarding as bouncing a ball. Kids know about the Grammy Awards and the Academy Awards and the Super Bowl. Do they know anything about recognition for scientists and engineers and inventors?
Name your top three favorite football players.
Oh, we got Geno Atkins, we got Aaron Rodgers, we got Devontae Freeman, Randall Cobb, and Cam Newton.
Okay, give me five, huh? Okay.
Yeah.
Name your top five engineers. What? Okay, top five scientists generally.
High school football player Orlando Garrett can laugh now, but when he joined his high school robotics team in Michigan 2 years ago, his grades were no laughing matter.
my freshman year, I wasn't really doing so well. Mm-hmm. So I was just not going to school and, you know, bad grades.
What was your GPA your freshman year?
My freshman year, the highest GPA for me was a 1.6.
That's not great.
Yeah, that's not good at all.
Nope.
No.
At the time, Orlando says, he thought about football and little else. Then he was recruited to compete for a different team at the school.
How's your GPA now?
3.2.
Wow.
Yeah, so robotics has helped me a lot.
Are you as competitive in robotics as you are in football?
Heck yeah. I love it. Like, I cheer on the teams like it was football. I mean, I can't, like, jump up and, you know, push them like I would in football, but, you know,
I would guess that'd be frowned upon.
Yeah, I get them a pat on the back and, like, let's go, let's get it, you know?
Come on, right there. Got it.
Now he's the team's driver.
Come on.
He controls the robot's every move on the field.
And another score by the Grizzlies.
Good job.
And he's begun to point himself in a new direction, too.
Was there a time when you thought your career could be football?
Yes, it was. Actually, my freshman year. And that really ended once I came in here and I just started, I fell in love with something else.
What do you want to be when you grow up? What do you want to do?
I want to be an engineer. You know, football, I don't think football is a lifelong job. Engineering, I feel like I can succeed like way more than I could in football.
At other schools, like this one in San Diego, young women are taking the lead and realizing their potential.
Wait, Udima, do they just go on top of each other like this?
Yeah.
Sisters Udima and Anika Shakya compete on the high-tech high robotics team in San Diego, known as the Holy Cows.
Can you get an eighth inch and tighten this?
Udima is also the director of engineering, part of a group of girls who run the team.
And this is 1 point plus.
We have 5 women out of 6 in our leadership positions.
Wow, so 5 out of the 6 leadership positions are held by young women.
Yes. Yeah.
What do you think of that?
I think that's really awesome. Like, that doesn't happen a lot.
The motors are really strong. I mean, it's a 300-to-1 ratio.
You can see a lot of our teams have very assertive women, young women, driving their teams. They're not there to be cheerleaders. They're not there to be supportive. They're there to participate, to compete, and to show what they can do.
Now, the Holy Cows are one of their school's main sources of pride.
At our school, it's like the Holy Cows is like, oh, that's one of the best teams that we have. And everyone just gets excited about it.
The whole school supports you.
Yeah. Most people, unless you live in a hole, know who we are. And they're like, wow, they build robots? Like, I wish I could do that.
3, 2, 1!
With more than 90,000 kids competing this year, it seems that Dean Kamen's invention is a certified success. But Kamen himself, true to form, can't help but wonder what still could be.
So when you look around and see all this, what do you think? Do you feel like it's been tremendous growth? You've been wildly successful?
Here's what I think when I look around. I think simultaneously with excitement and with disappointment. The excitement to me is these kids have learned so much. These kids have had their life changed by this. But I'm disappointed because this represents a tiny fraction of all kids.
Please welcome the founder of FIRST, Dean Kamen.
Despite his frustration, Kamen remains hopeful that his new age sport will be the culture shift no one saw coming.
I think there'll come a time very soon when robotics is way more relevant to the average kid than most of the things that now dominate what they think are the key pieces of sports. And as robotics becomes assimilated into what they do every day, using it as part of their sports culture will become ever, ever, ever larger piece of our culture.
Thanks much for watching. Remember, you can catch the rest of the latest edition of Real Sports all month long on HBO.